All right, so I'm going to be talking about my mock backend workflow. And basically what I mean by this is that when I make an HTTP request, instead of that request going to the server, it gets intercepted and a mocked or stubbed data gets returned to me while in development. So the tools that I use for this are the ngMockE end-to-end module, Gulp, and AngularMockBack. AngularMockBack is actually a utility that I wrote with a friend specifically because of this talk, because I realized that 5 minutes was nowhere near enough to talk about everything I wanted to. So I can talk about that instead. So there's a sample project about everything I'm going to be talking about. It's a little bit simple, but it definitely gets the point across, and it's pretty similar to how I use this in the real world. So the advantages to this workflow for me are basically everything that's on the slide, but more importantly, it gives me speed. And anything that gives me speed while still allowing me to have control is something that I always want in my tool set. So with that said, I'm going to just jump right in. And I'm going to be talking first with Gulp. So everything starts with Gulp for me because I want to create a separate index file, one that has the live services and then the index-mb in this example, because I want to be able to have the mock and the live version so I can switch back and forth. The reason for this is because I found that I'm pretty lazy, and if it's not easy for me to switch back and forth, I won't check the services when they're available, and then there will be an error or a bug that I have to deal with down the line. So this is a very simple step, but it's definitely very important for me. And that takes us to AngularMockBack. So it takes care of the HTTP backend decoration. Thank you, Wojta, who wrote the JS fiddle for that. And it gives you really fine control over the responses that you're gonna get. You actually, with AngularMockBack, you can actually take your response and switch it on the fly. So that level of control is really useful. So you can get on Bower and GitHub. I'll put the links up again in the slides online later. So it all starts with a config object. This config object needs a module name so it knows what to decorate, and then it needs an array of mappings. So each one of these mappings, they take the same parameters as the HTTP backend.when function, but also you need the response and the status code. But in this example, I'm using only the URL in the body simply because I'm defaulting to a method of get and a status code of 200. That way I save some keystrokes. So once you have your mapping, all you have to do is pass it to AngularMockBack, and or your config, all you have to do is pass it to AngularMockBack and you're good to go. So the really cool thing for me is in AngularMockBack is that in this scenario, I'm passing in a user. And let's say you have an application that this user has edit capabilities. Well, what if I want to see my application in like view-only mode? Like if I didn't have edit capabilities on this user. So the answer to that is overrides. So all you have to do is pass an override to your mapping, and then you can have as many overrides as you want and that overrides property. And then you just give it a name and what property or you want to override. So in this case, I'm just changing the sample data and passing in one for a user no edit in this scenario. So how do you actually use these overrides? Well, this is what I really like. You just pass it in as a query parameter right after your index. So that way it doesn't conflict with your router. And you can actually mix and match, stack as many overrides as you want. So in this example, I'm using the view only for the user, the no edit. And I'm also showing advanced settings. So let's say that you couldn't see advanced settings, now you can. So this is extremely useful, especially for like you don't have to log out an account that has super permissions and you want to check something that has less permissions. This saves you a lot of time. So basically, to wrap it all up, it's query parameter driven responses. It's easier to set up multiple states. Like I'll have a bunch of a folder with a bunch of bookmarks that I'll just click and check the application that way. And it's extremely useful for end-to-end tests if you can't test live services at that moment. And that's all I have.